Hi everybody, in this video we are going to discuss the classification of audit on the basis of degree of independence. So on the basis of degree of independence, auditing is classified into three: internal audit, external auditing and branch auditing. So let us see in detail what is internal audit, external audit and branch audit. Internal audit. In large companies, in order to detect and prevent errors and frauds, the continuous audit is carried out by a paid employee of the company. So, some undertakings appoint auditors for constant and regular checking of accounts. Such arrangement is known as internal auditing. So, internal auditing means in a internal employee, an employee will be appointed in the company in order to find out the errors and frauds or in order to prevent or in order to detect the errors and frauds that is coming under the books of accounts of the company. So, and internally an employee will be appointed by the company to check all these aspects. So, if that particular employee is verifying the books of accounts of the company in order to detect and prevent errors and frauds, then we can call it as internal auditing. And internal auditing is an independent appraisal of activity within an organization for a review of operations by measuring and evaluating the effectiveness of other controls. So internal auditing means, in short, we can say that in large companies, in order to detect and prevent errors and frauds, a continuous audit is done by a paid employee of the company. If an employee is verifying the books of accounts in order to prevent and detect errors and frauds, then such type of auditing is known as internal auditing. And in case of internal auditing, a separate department is maintained for internal audit in big organizations, which is known as internal audit department. In case of large organizations, there will be some departments that is set in order to do the auditing work. Such department is known as internal audit department, and salaried auditors or sometimes maybe the full staff appointed to do so. So internal auditing is done in order to do the auditing work internally by the company and organization. So when they are appointing an auditor annually in order to check their books of accounts, it may be very difficult for the auditor to check all the books of accounts within a specified time period. So a company, they themselves, they will be appointing an employee in order to check the books of accounts of the company. Such type of checking is known as internal auditing. And next one is external auditing. So external auditing means when a business appoints a professional auditor for a fixed remuneration, and if an auditing is done by that professional auditor, then we can call it as an external audit. In case of internal audit, an employee will be appointed by the company in order to do the auditing work. But in case of external auditing, an external auditor or a professional auditor is appointed only for a fixed period of time by paying a fixed remuneration. Such type of auditing is known as external auditing. So it is the duty and responsibility of the auditors. Auditor, if they have appointed as an auditor, then they have to conduct the auditing in the company. Then the external auditor is required to give his report to the company, and he is also accountable to the client and sometimes to the third parties also for the work done by him. So, in case of external audit, not only the professional person will be doing the auditing work, not only a single person will be doing the auditing work. Sometimes he may also appoint his subordinates to check the auditing or check the books of accounts of the company. If he is doing any, if he is appointing any subordinates, then the auditor will be responsible for the subordinates appointed by him also. So that is known as external auditing. So internal auditing means if an employee is appointed by the company to look after their auditing work, we call it as internal auditing. If an external employee is appointed for a specific period of time for a fixed remuneration in order to look after the books of accounts, then we call it as external audit. And the third one is branch audit. In case of a joint stock company, a branch auditing will also be done. For example, if a company is having several branches in different states or different places, then if an auditing is done in all those branches, then we call it as branch audit. A statutory auditor of company is responsible for the audit of branch accounts. And according to Section 228, if and branch office is there outside India, then an auditing should also be done in that particular branch office also. Where account are audited other than the company's auditor, it is known as branch audit. In different branches, some other branch account auditors will also be doing the auditing work. Where in general meeting, the person other than the auditor should be appointed by the board of directors. If any there will be a particular auditor to the company, not only he is doing the auditing work, some other persons are also doing the auditing work, then in the general meeting they should appoint an auditor, and this should be appointed by the board of directors of the company also. Branch auditor is having specific duties that is specified, and he should also possess the required qualification. He is also having the responsibility. He should be paid with the remuneration, and he is having all powers of the auditor also, and all these things will be decided by the board of directors of the company. The duties of the branch auditor, his qualifications, his responsibility, the remuneration paid, and the power of auditor is decided by the board of directors in case of branch audit. So this is about branch audit. So auditing done in different branches of a company is known as branch audit. So we are discussing the classification of auditing on the basis of degree of independence. On the basis of degree of independence, auditing is classified into three: internal audit, external audit, and branch audit. If an employee is appointed in the company and if he is doing the auditing work in a regular basis, then we can say it is an internal audit. If an external auditor is appointed in the company for a specified period of time for a fixed remuneration, then we can call it as external audit. And if auditing is done in different branches of a company, then we can call it as branch audit. So that's all about classification of auditing on the basis of degree of independence. Thank you all for listening to me. Next classifications we can study in the next video. Thank you all.